Broad Street today, Birmingham's Golden Mile, regarded by many people as the city's most important street, not only for entertainment and leisure, but also for conferences, conventions, concerts, exhibitions, learning and banking. And in the 19th century, Broad Street was also viewed by many as the most important street in Birmingham. But then it was for its industries, like the famed brasswork of Winfield's, which stood on the site of the present Library of Birmingham. Nearby was the headquarters of Nettlefold's, one of the biggest producers of iron screws in the world, and later part of GKN. Black Sabbath Bridge, honouring Birmingham's legendary heavy metal rockers, and a major feature on Broad Street's Walk of Stars, which highlights famous people connected to the city. But 100 years ago, this bridge was more famous for the church which spanned the canal, the Church of the Messiah, for it was here that worshipped some of the most influential and powerful families in the city, like the Chamberlains, and it was also the focal point of Birmingham's women's movement. The bridge also connects us with the late 18th century, the time when Birmingham launched itself onto the world stage as a city of a thousand trades. And why was that? Because of this canal, the Birmingham Canal, which allowed Birmingham's wares to reach a global market. Broad Street was once a country lane, but the cutting of the canals was the catalyst for the urban onslaught which swept away the countryside. But here and there, one or two street names call out to us of the rural past. The Sheepcote Street, pronounced by older Brummies as Sheepcote. A cot was a cottage, and there were sheep hereabouts. And nearby was the Roozles, a farm which has left its name in Ouzel Street. That farm and others quickly disappeared in the early 19th century and were replaced by factories, workshops and badly built back-to-back houses. The poor of Birmingham, who lived in those back-to-backs, were as responsible and influential in creating the workshop of the world as were the wealthy industrialists. But their story has too often been neglected and overlooked. The end of Broad Street, right by Five Ways, one of the busiest junctions in Birmingham. And it's right by Edgbaston, where the wealthy of the city moved to from the 1820s. Most of them cared little about the poor that lived nearby, but there were a few who gave something back. One of them was a man called Christian Kunzel. He was a master chocolatier from Switzerland, and he set up a confectionery business in Birmingham, here at the end of Broad Street. He was also a philanthropist who gave lots of money to the Birmingham Children's Hospital. And just over the road is a statue to Joseph Sturge, one of the most distinguished men to belong to Birmingham. He was an anti-slavery campaigner, an educationalist, a political reformer, a pacifist. He was known by many people as Birmingham's best friend.